Hey guys, Frozen Neptunia here, and yeah, there was a bit of a delay because I, got distracted. I'm back to record another episode of Tales of, I said Tales of Graces, didn't I? I do need to return to that series, but yeah, Final Fantasy X, another JRPG that's very close to my heart. And yeah, I've always noticed like the little like sort of dreamlike effect here. Hopefully this episode is going to be a little shorter, seeing as I am actually recording this at about 10:05 at night, only because my mum's gone out to a party. So this cutscene here isn't very dialogue heavy. It's just I could have showed this at the end of the last episode if I wanted this one to be shorter, but I forgot I had plans tomorrow, so I couldn't record this episode tomorrow. I'm recording it now. And I thought there would be a bigger turnout for a summoner leaving. In all honesty, I'm not a big fan of goodbyes. No, it's more like I don't get emotional in a goodbye. I'm just like, how am I supposed to react? Because if you actually like spend some time with me in real life, you would quickly learn that I'm not frightfully sarcastic, but I come off as very sarcastic, despite my autism saying that I don't really understand. I don't understand when people use autism. Wait, use autism. Use sarcasm. Yeah, you can tell it's 10:05 at night. I am not... Well, I am an insomniac, so I don't tend to sleep anyway. So yeah, this is actually still early for me. Like, late for me is like early hours in the morning. And Tita's checking out Lulu there. He's got some pretty good taste. I think it's just the red eyes that do it for me. Like going off on a tangent, I think like when it comes to anime girls, it's either red or green eyes for me. Like, I have this like particular hair eye combo that I like with those two eyes. With red eyes, it's always white or black hair. I don't know why, I just love that sort of like combination. But then the other side of it with the green eyes, it's green eyes and green hair. I don't know why, I just like it. But yeah, we're on the SS Leaky. I wouldn't get on a boat that has its name as Leaky. I want to talk to this guy. Yeah, this is the guy that Tita stole the binoculars off. Yes. No way. Remember what you did last time? Okay. But then you're just like, no. And he's like, I see. Well, I don't want you to borrow my thing. Well, it's not like I wanted you to borrow them or anything, bucker. Sorry. Just had to do the sundere thing there. Yeah, as I was saying, like, it's just like, I can't help but like that. I don't know why. It's mainly because of one of the new, for God's sake, I actually forgot about this guy being here. Owaka. I just love his name, Owaka. It's just like saying it, just like how he says it. Owaka the 23rd, at your
don't
service.
Look like you got much money either.
Out of me way.
I've no business with you. Out of me way.
I just love that accent they gave him.
Owaka the 23rd, merchant extraordinary.
Owaka the who?
Owaka the who?
It's just like one of these names I just love. Like, well, I honestly should start recording. Like, if I was in my own place, I would definitely be recording more at night than editing, than uploading the video, so I'm less tired, because you can definitely hear by my voice that I'm much more talkative. But yeah, if we talk to Owaka, we can actually lend him Gil. Let's lend him 100, because I've already, I've actually gave him about 10,000 on the profile I'm using, because I grinded a lot of money. But if we go in here, there is a chest, I believe. Yeah, There's a chest and a briefcase. You can actually kick this briefcase 20 times to get 20 free potions. So that's why I should have said in the last episode, don't bother buying them back in Besaid, because you can just get 20 of them here. Yeah, you're not going to see me like do any grinding, because I'm just showing you everything on the ship, because this episode is literally just two boss fights.
What the heck is that?
Wait.
What the heck is
Did
what?
I put my phone on charge?
What is this place?
Eh, no, screw it. Like I'll do it later.
Yeah, but why the big
birds? Actually, next question.
What's so strange about
Where
chocobo
is my phone?
Chocobos? Those are chocobos?
What?
Oh, I left the mic on.
Chocobo?
Okay. The reason why I was saying that is because it's mainly because Miracles my eldest sister's coming down tomorrow and we're all going bowling. I just know my sisters are going to find some way to cheat. Like, they try to cheat almost anything, so I'm not looking forward to it, and plus my right wrist is hurting, at the moment, don't look at it that way. I may use my right wrist quite a lot, but I'm just digging myself a deeper hole now, aren't I? But yeah, now, what does Waka have to say? Oh, you can actually talk to Waka now.
Come to think of it, I haven't told you where we're going. First to Kilika Island, then we change boats and head for Luca. For that though, Yuna's gotta pray at the temple. I'll be guarding. We'll be praying for the Auroch's victory too, so you come along, yeah?
Great plan.
Hey, it is a great plan.
Don't look at me.
In all honesty, me and Lulu would actually get on pretty well, seeing as we can be caring. We can actually both be very caring. But just lines like that, very sarcastic, somewhat condescending. Can I kick the blitzball? No. God damn it. Yeah, it's just okay, wait, what was I talking about? No, the first thing that I was going on about, what was it? Wow, I suck at staying on one topic. I've actually forgotten the other things I was going to go on about.
Word is, that summoner's got noble blood. I heard she's Lord Braska's daughter. You don't say.
Lord Braska's daughter?
So, coincidentally, Yuna has a pretty impressive parent. What do you have to say? Don't you shake your head at me. It's up to me whether or not I use you in this game. I'm sorry, but in every playthrough I've done, I rarely ever use Kimari. We can actually see his grid now. I'll show you why. And if I zoom... No. If I zoom out, you can see that everyone else is in pretty close proximity to Kimari. Yeah. Kimari doesn't actually have his own path. He just follows someone else's. I tend to have him follow Lulu's, mainly because he becomes a bit more of a tanky mate. I personally, if I teach him black magic, I use him more than Lulu. In all honesty, Lulu... Kimari has better health, he has better defenses. As we would see, he has 15 to Yuna's 8. Not Yuna, Lulu's 8. But he doesn't have as much magic defense, which he will get in Lulu's grid. I take him down Lulu's grid if I want him to be a bit more tanky during the main game. Just so he has better things for a certain boss that we'll be fighting many times later. But yeah, it's just so he's more balanced that way. Just trying to see who's actually got the highest luck. Huh, it's Waka. That's rather weird, actually. But yeah, now we've got to go back over and talk to Waka. I wonder what my brothers are going on about.
Is his father famous or something?
Oh, they're complaining about bowling tomorrow.
Statue at the temple. Braska defeated sin 10 years ago.
Bad thing about brothers is that they can be so really just damn competitive. Good thing I'm going to be out most of the day tomorrow.
It's tough.
And
when your father's famous.
I actually never knew how good soda streams were. Yeah, I actually have a soda stream in my bedroom. Huh? And the
thanks, Lulu.
I believe I'm. Hold on, let me just reach for the bottle. I am drinking the cola naturally flavored sparkling mix. Yeah, the cola flavored stuff for soda stream. It actually tastes pretty good. I'll save the other tirade I was going to go on for later. Let's just do this other cutscene, which I have been talking through the cutscenes. I actually think it would be better for me to talk through some of the cutscenes just to gauge my reactions, in a sense, because I have a lot of reactions to do with this game anyway. And he's just approaching Yuna. One quick thing that I have noticed is the look on Yuna's face when she moves. I don't understand it, but it just looks a bit like, oh, it's you. I guess you can stand next to me. Like, I've never really understood, like, Yuna's expression there. Like, how she looks somewhat hesitant to move at first. But I'm a guy. What the hell do we understand about girls, am I right?
The wind. It's nice.
I just look at Tidus's goofy smile.
You're a blitzball player, aren't you? From Xanarkin, right?
You hear that from Waka?
Mm-hmm.
Huh. Waka. Waka doesn't believe me at all.
But I believe you.
Huh?
I've heard in Xanarkin, there is a great stadium, all lit up, even at night.
Huh?
Great blitzball tournaments are held there, and the stands are always full.
How do you know that?
A man named Jack told me. He was my father's guardian.
Jack. My father. His name is Jack.
Amazing! You know, our meeting like this must be the blessing of Yevon.
Sounds like him, but it can't be him.
Why not?
My old man, he died. 10 years ago, off the coast of Xanarkin.
I'm sorry.
He went out to sea for training one day, and never came back. And no one's seen him since then.
Why, that's the day that Jekt came to Spira.
But...
It's true, I first met Jekt 10 years and 3 months ago. I remember that was the day my father left. The date fits, doesn't it?
Yeah, but how would he get here?
You're here? Are you not?
Huh?
What do you think you're doing? Stick a harpoon in him and we'll all get dragged under.
Zin is going for Killika. We gotta distract him.
Our families are in Killika. Forgive us, Lady Summoner.
Wait! Oh boy.
Okay, what did I miss? In all honesty, I kind of got bored of the cutscene, muted my mic, and started watching anime. I am probably the only YouTuber... Yeah, and I really shouldn't be talking through a cutscene, but I'm probably the only, like, Let's Player who just got bored in a cutscene and started watched the end of, what episode was it? Episode 2 of, Kobayashi-san Chino Maid Dragon. I'm going through the dub just to see, like, what the voice acting's like, and in all honesty, we actually have one of the easiest bosses in the game. Right, switch to Waka. In all honesty, this boss can get a little annoying. Like, I'll actually show you, if you don't want to do this fight the way I normally do it, I actually spent 3 hours on this boss grinding. Yeah, you can grind this boss indefinitely. Right, yeah, so you want to just keep hitting the fin, that's how you win the fight. But here's how to have the easiest time in this fight, if you just want to end it quickly. Kill off 2 of the Sin Scales, and, let me just turn off my iPad so I can not say where he's in charge. Now I'm going to bring out, take Tidus out, and then just, doesn't really matter what you cast, I'm going to cast Ice, because favorite element is obvious Ice. Just keep hitting it with Waka and Lulu and it will eventually die. This boss is actually very boring. Now I'm going to bring out Yuna just in case I need to heal. I could bring out Valafor. And I was actually... what I'm actually going to be doing from now on with the Aeons is actually naming them after some of my friends. So it's like... Oh, my friends are coming to aid me in this game. Because you remember my Dark Souls, well, my first profile on Dark Souls and my Demon Souls Let's Play, I named the characters after 2 of my friends. I am going to do that with the Aeons, if I don't forget. I'm probably just going to pick the names at random, so it is not going to match. So, yeah, I'm probably just going to randomly pick a name to an Aeon when it's time to actually do the thing. But yeah, we just want to keep hitting this. We want to save Waka's MP for the next boss, because I haven't done any grinding. So this boss is going to be... The next boss is really annoying if you haven't grind, if you don't grind. Yuna, heal Lulu, because it's just, we don't want them dying, because... unfortunately, this episode might go over 30 minutes, because... I'm literally doing no damage, and these two are the only two that can damage it. If I taught Yuna Blizzard, which... I should have made a save before I'm... just now I'm realizing this. Although, one thing I do find really interesting, later on, as we see in Sin's design, is that it actually has 2 fins. Where's the other one? And... Come on, is this going to kill it? Please kill it. Please kill it. Anyway, like I was saying... Kobayashi-san Chino Maid Dragon is, it, for the original series, like not counting like second seasons, it's probably... It's definitely tied for my second favourite anime of the season. Because it's tied currently with Gabriel Dropout, which... God, I recommend that series. I recommend both of them. Because they are just such good series. Just... My words can't do them enough justice. So, I recommend... Go to your local anime site... And watch it. Watch both Kobayashi-san Chino Maid Dragon and... Gabriel Dropout. Yeah. I got something stuck in my teeth. Yeah, I ate an apple before recording, and you know, like, this is gonna sound really random, but you know how you eat apples and you get the skin stuck in your teeth? Yeah, it's basically that. There we go. I think my mic actually picked that up. And I'm actually regretting not eating anything. I tend to actually get very hungry this time of night. And Walker's Blitzball doing some voodoo magic there. And yeah, Tidus is knocked. I'm actually surprised his lungs aren't full of water. And that was a high potion animation, not a Phoenix Down animation. Although, one thing I've always wondered. What? Oh, wait. Dolphins? Oh. You. I hate this thing. In my very first playthrough of this game, this boss gave me so much trouble because I didn't know how to fight it. And back then, internet wasn't really a thing that we really had in the house. But yeah, last time I had the scouts equipped to Waka, so yeah, I didn't grind that. But yeah, this boss is very annoying. And it only has about 1500 health. And there's its main gimmick. But what I was saying is that... What is that thing on Waka's arm? On his left arm, that weird, like, cup thing? Because I have no idea what it is. And yeah, literally this fight... This fight is, in my honest opinion, really tedious. Because we've constantly got these little things respawning. Its drain touch is a bit weird. And everything like that. You just got to keep hitting it. I think this fight's done very soon. Oh, joy, Blender. Around and around we go. And miraculously end up in the same place. I recommend, like, don't heal until your health is in the amber. And, of course, I don't kill it, do I? Because it's me. I never can kill things when I want them to. And, yeah, that's the main gimmick of Draining Touch. Can you die already? Boop. And it's not dead. Underwater bosses will get a little more interesting later. Like, this is the... Well, second underwater boss. And it's dead. I booped it to death. Death by booping. Just a quick stretch. Hopefully this episode will be under 30 minutes, because I've got to edit and render it tonight. Yeah, I'll just stay up for it, because my friends will probably be online. Red arm guard and blue arm guard. Will you pick the red pill or will you pick the blue pill? I'm sorry, but yeah. interesting little tidbit. You can actually do this the first boss so many times that you can do it for so long. I've gotten 99 power spheres, 99 mana spheres, and 99 speed spheres. Yes, I did it for that long. And cutscene! I hope my microphone did not pick that up, but my stomach just rumbled. Yeah, I'll probably just have some toast later before... Meh. I'm going to be up for ages anyway, so... Pff, who cares? And let's sit back and watch all the innocent destruction. This is why you don't make your houses out of wood, people. Well, they're definitely dead. What are those flying things? Yep, he's dead. They are most definitely dead. But yeah, this is one thing I do not understand. We actually see later on how big Sin actually is. And shouldn't he technically be more out of the water? Because it's just a little thing I've noticed about this game. It's just like Sin's proportion like kind of changes. Because in all honesty, if he's that big... We would see a whole lot more of him if he's that close to the Isle of Killica.
I will defeat Sin.
Yeah, we'll get to that later.
I was just fooling myself. Maybe it was that day on the sea, under the burning sun. I started to give up.
Well, we know Killica is kind of in a bad shape right now.
I wasn't going home.
So let's hope everything's still okay.
This was my new reality, and I was stuck in it for good.
Although, wait a minute. Why are the temples always untouched by Sin? That's just one thing I've always wanted to know. Like, okay, if Sin goes, we'll destroy everything near it, as we hear a bit later. All it does is destroy. How come the temples never end up getting destroyed? Yeah, I know they're always inland, and apparently Sin can only travel through water until we find out later on that's technically not true. Like, it's pretty confusing, like, especially when we get to the late game when we start getting explanations for Sin. I'm just giving you a warning now.
I am the summoner Yuna. I have come from the temple in Bisade.
Oh, Milady Summoner!
If there is no
I think
other
we may
here,
hit 30 minutes exactly.
Ah, thanks, BT.
Our loved ones. We feared they
Yeah. Can we do this? Because I want to say. Well, I want to finish the episode so I can move over to the next profile for when I record probably tomorrow night after bowling. Hopefully I should be able to do that, unless by some miracle I forget about this Let's Play again. Because knowing me, that's going to happen at some point. But yeah, we survived two boss encounters. One was a complete pushover, and the other I tend to find pretty annoying. So, we arrive in Killica, and on the next episode, you'll be seeing a much stronger version of my party. This has been Frozen Neptunia, and I'll see all you lovely people in the next episode. Bye for now.